Hello students, in this video we study about harmonic distortion analyzer. So first we will study what is harmonic distortion, what is the total harmonic distortions, what are the reasons for the harmonic distortions occur in electronic circuits. Then we will see the block diagram for the basic harmonic distortion analyzer. So let us start with our topic. Okay, so distortion, what is the distortion? Whenever we are applying the input to the device, we are getting some output. Okay, if output is exactly replica of the input, means exactly equal to the input, then there is no distortion. In case if output is not exactly equal to the input, we call it as a distortion, means there is some sort of disturbance. Okay, suppose we are giving the input as a sinusoidal input waveform and output will be a non-sinusoidal signal or any other signal, then we call it as a distortion, some sort of distortion is there. Okay, application of a sinusoidal input to an electronic device does not result in the output waveform which is an exact replica of the input because of various types of distortions. These distortions occur due to the non-linear characteristics of different components. That non-linear characteristics introduces harmonics in the output waveform. Okay, those harmonics we call it as an harmonic distortion. Okay, so these are the various types of distortions. First one is the frequency distortion, means when we are passing the input through a device, the output means the amplification factor present in the amplifier is different for the different frequencies. So if any disturbance in the frequency, then we call it as a frequency distortion. Second one is the phase distortion. Okay, so whenever we are applying the input, so the energy storage elements in the system is affected or displaced in a phase, changing the phase factors, then we call it as a phase distortion. And third one is the amplitude distortion. So the amplitude of the amplifier, generates the harmonics of the fundamental input signal, then we call it as a amplitude distortion. And when we are mixing two signals, mixing is nothing but heterodyny. Okay, so when we are mixing two frequencies, the output is some more difference of two original frequencies. If any disturbance occurs, then we call it as an intermodulation distortion. And the last one is called as crossover distortion. Means when we are using the push-pull amplifier, incorrect bias levels will cause the crossover distortion. So these are the various distortions. First one is due to the frequency changes. Second one is due to the phase changes. Third one is the amplitude. Fourth one is the when we are mixing the two signals, the changes caused is nothing but intermodulation. When we are connections are incorrect, then we will get crossover distortion. So let us talk about total harmonic distortion. Okay, so a nonlinear system produces the harmonics of an input sine wave. The harmonic consists of sine waves with frequencies which are multiples of the fundamental of the input signal. Suppose our input signal is f and output we are getting is multiples of the fundamental frequencies, that is 2f, 3f, 4f, etc. Okay. So total harmonics is measured in terms of harmonic content of the wave. Okay, accurately we using the harmonic distortion analyzer. means this is the formula for the total harmonic distortion, which is the square root of summation of all the harmonics, okay, by fundamental harmonic, okay. So the distortion, it is represented by the ratio of the harmonic to that of fundamental. Okay, suppose if you want to measure the second harmonic, then the formula for that is D2 is equals to E2 by E1. If you want to measure the third hormone, third distortion, D3 is equal to E3 by En. If you want to measure the nth one, Dn is equals to En by E1. Okay. So, simplest method to suppress the fundamental frequency of the signal is with, okay. So, if you substitute those formulas in this, the sum of the all harmonics. So, sum of the all harmonics means D2 plus D3 plus D4, so on, Dn by D1. Okay, E1. D2 is nothing but E2 by E1. D3 is nothing but E3 by E1. D4 is nothing but E4 by E1. Like that, we will get the formula. This formula will get. Okay, if you want to find out the percentage of these harmonics, the formula is DTH means THD is nothing but total harmonic distortion into 100. Okay, so where EF is nothing but the amplitude of the fundamental frequency, and E1, E2, E3, so on, En are the amplitudes of the individual harmonics. Okay, so this is the block diagram of the harmonic distortion analyzer. This one we call it as a manual system. This one is the automatic system. Okay, so this block diagram is used to measure the total harmonic distortion, which consists of a notch filter, which is used to remove the harmonics and it passes only the individual signal. Okay. So, if you observe in the first figure, what we are having harmonic used to measure the signal, the signal source will have the very low distortion, okay, and this can be checked by the reading its output distortion by connecting directly into the analyzer. The signal from the source is fed to the amplifier under test, and this generates the harmonics and original fundamental frequency. So, here from here we are giving the input signal, okay. So, here what it will amplify the input signal, and the output will be the harmonics plus fundamental frequency. ET plus ET. Okay. So, ET is nothing but fundamental components plus harmonic components. Okay. This is giving to the notch filter. Okay. Notch filter will do what? It will remove all the harmonics and it will pass us only the So, what will do? It suppresses the fundamental frequency and passes only the harmonics. So, this is the switch which we are going to use manually. Okay. If you want to find out the total distortion, that is fundamental plus harmonic, then we have to connect it to the switch one. And if you want to know only the harmonics of the signal, then we have to connect to the switch 2 and the indicator will display the result. Okay. So E1 is going to give the total amplitude of the frequency. Second switch will going to give the harmonics, amplitudes of the harmonics. Okay. This second figure is nothing but similar figure, same figure. Instead of using the manual switch, it will automatically find out the RMS values, means EH values and ET values directly, and find out the ratio of this ET by EH, and it will going to indicate the it will show on a indicator. Okay, so the procedure of these two is same, but in the first figure we are manually changing the position of switch 1 and switch 2. In the second figure, in here it is automatically calculates the EH and ET, and it will find out directly the ratio of these two and going to give the output of the ratio. Okay, so if you observe it, in this notch filter is common. It removes the fundamental component from the signal. It gives the good accuracy, excellent rejection, and it will consist of high pass categories. Okay, characteristics. Okay. It should attenuate the fundamental by 100 dB or more, harmonics by less than 1 dB. Filter also needed to tune to accurately to the fundamental of the signal source. Okay. So, for this, what we are having? So, in the second figure, what we are having, all the values of AL, ET and EH are read simultaneously, and their ratio calculated and displayed as total harmonic distortion on the indicator. Okay. So, with the help of the notch filter, we will get the good accuracy and excellent rejection and high pass characteristics. Okay. So, the example of this is, notch filter is Wien bridge. It is also a form of, Wien bridge is a common form of the notch filter, which balances at one frequency only, and at this frequency the output voltage of the bridge of the null detector is minimum. Okay. In this video we studied that what is harmonic distortion analyzer. First we studied that what the distortion and how the total harmonic distortion calculated. After that we studied the two block diagrams. One is which is using the annual system in the harmonic distortion analyzer, and second one is using the ratio method to total harmonic distortion. So I hope that this topic now clear to you.